something kind of amazing has happened. I'm going to finally be paid to do some archaeology. I'm going north to hunt for shipwrecks.
I can't tell you how amazing this is. I've spent 4.5 years retraining out of project management and IT and all of that gumph into a fantastically just magnificent industry of archaeology. It comes with the allure of adventure and discovery, and it has just been so fulfilling doing my degree. I have 13 weeks left to go and my degree is done, but I've already got a bit of paid archaeology. This is amazing. Okay, where am I going? I should tell you, three parts to this trip. First part is, it's gonna be awesome. First part of this trip is we're primarily going north to talk to this guy called who's a fairly, you know, famous Australian shipwreck diver around Australia, has dived pretty much every ship that there is. He may know the location of some unreported wrecks. So we're going north to talk to him. Also talk to him a little bit about his collection. He has accrued a large collection of artifacts from shipwrecks. A lot of this was collected before the laws were brought in, because you can't do that anymore. Second part of the trip is there's some shipwreck cannon or something like that that's being donated to a museum, so we're going to go check that out. I don't know too many of the details on that. But the third part, the coolest part, it comes with a bit of a story. I need to rewind about 2 weeks. A bunch of weeks ago, we were looking at a YouTube video of a guy exposing a wreck on a beach somewhere north of Port Douglas, between Port Douglas and Cape Tribulation. And somewhere in there, did a bit of CSI work and looked at all the beaches in Google Earth and tried to match them up with the environment that we could see in the video. We narrowed it down to a couple of beaches, and that combined that with some historical resources and narrowed it down that the beach was probably Cow Beach. We're taking some metal detectors, we're taking some recording equipment, and we're going to see if we can find this beach. Find the wreck on this beach. So what is the ship? You know, we're not entirely sure. We think it might be a ship called the Index, which sunk about 4 miles or nautical miles off the coast, right off the coast of this beach, in 1898. It's about 70 something feet long. That's quite likely what it is, but we can confirm that by getting those wood samples out of the wreck, assuming we find it, and getting those looked at by a what's the term for a wood archaeologist specialist guy? Dendrochronologist something. I'll figure it out. I'm going on this trip with Paddy. Paddy also works for EHP. He is the I wish I could remember his job title. It's something like maritime demigod archaeologist super being or something like that. He has taken me under his wing and we're going up together, and it should be fun. Archaeology is so much fun. I can't tell you, it's amazing physical and intellectual journey that is better than any mystery, whodunit, whatever. I just, you know, it just blows my mind. Hopefully I can impart a bit of that amazingness through this video to you guys.
One more time, baby.
Okay, it's Monday morning, about 5:30 in the morning. I'm on my way to Cairns. Got to get ready to go. Plane leaves in a few hours.
And I gonna feel hard.
So we got to the airport. Patty and I were waiting for the waiting to board. They called boarding. Patty got a phone call. Phone call was from the person we were going up to interview, cancelling because they had been to Papua New Guinea and had a chest infection. And so Patty said, right, well, we've got to not board and get our bags off the plane. Got our bags off the plane and we went into the office and did a normal day's work. That kind of sucked. So it's postponed. We'll try again in a few weeks. That kind of ends that sucky story. Sorry.
Oh baby, what a place to be. In the service of the bourgeoisie.